Good morning, students. So, in this video, I am going to explain about the types of essays. So, I'm not going to take all the types of essays, but few. So, firstly, essay writing, we all know that it's a common school or a college assignment, you know that. And a part of standardized tests, it's a requirement on college applications that you need to attempt an essay. And these days, even for like interviews for screening, even people or to filter members, people are just conducting essay writing too. So, firstly, before starting to write the introduction, conclusion, the parts of an essay, or else the structure of an essay and all, it's important you should understand the topic and under which kind of an essay the topic comes under. So, I will just give you like the few four kinds of essays here. Hope you all can see this. Yeah, so there are four major types of essays. So here, first, before starting to write an essay, it is important that you should understand the topic comes under which kind of an essay. So first one, it is narrative essay. So narrative essay is that, so being so clear, I have given it in a single phrase, that telling a story. So telling a story comes under narrative. So if anything is being described so clearly, so because story cannot be like a summarized one. If it is given like a summarized, it will be called as an outline of a movie, outline of a story, but it will not be called as like telling a story. So here, narrative essays will be like telling a story. So the writer tells a story about a real life experience even. So in narration is that it may sound so easy to do, but that this kind of an essay is like a challenge to students to think and to write about themselves. And when writing this kind of a narrative essays, the writer should try to involve the reader by making the story as vivid as possible. So you have to be so clear in your narration. So using some pronouns or using third person or whatever, he, she. So people should understand, because you are going to explain each and everything in your narrative essay. So you have to be so clear, you have to be obvious that. So the reader should understand, okay, so the person is referring he to the first sentence, name or anything like that. It has to be that clear. So here, narrative essays will also build towards drawing a conclusion or making a personal statement. So narrative, because it is given each and every sentence so clearly, so people will be like taking, so they just draw conclusions out of it. They just make some general statements out of your essay. And the second essay is that descriptive essays. So a story cannot be descriptive, okay? Like what you can describe is that whatever you can see, you can describe. So a movie you have watched, yes, you can describe a movie. But you have listened the story and you cannot describe a story over there. So in a single phrase, I have given that painting a picture, it comes under descriptive essays. So you have seen that a picture has been painted, and on that you can start describing. It means you can describe a person because you have seen. You can describe a place you have visited. You can describe an object which you have, for instance, a mobile. Yes, you have it in your hand. You can start describing. Or even a memory of special significance. Because, see, sometimes we have watched a nice movie which just stores in our mind like that. You can start describing a movie because it is new in your mind, in your memory. So, however, this type of an essay is not description for description's sake. Okay. And this descriptive essay strives to communicate a deeper meaning through the description. You wanted to convey your sense of information to be conveyed, and that's the reason you have started a description. Okay. And the best descriptive essays appeal to the reader's emotion with a result that is highly evocative. Yes, So most of the best descriptive essays we call which essays or like takes the reader's emotions, which appeal the reader's emotions comes under descriptive essays. So in a single phrase, it has been called like painting a picture. Okay. So the third kind of an essay is that expository essay. So in a single phrase, I have given for each and every essay, what is meant by expository is that just taking the facts. So you're not talking about your self experience, you're not just describing what you have seen, but it's a fact. So for instance, you are just talking about like, of course, an old example about the sun rises in the east, because that's a fact you're talking about. So you can start writing an essay because, see, if it is your topic is given like sun rises in the east. So first you should come to a conclusion that yes, this kind of a topic comes under expository because it is a fact. So there's nothing you are describing. Imagine if sun rises in the east, or else that's not a story saying that once upon a time sun rises in the east. No, that's a fact, expository essay topic. And it is an informative piece of writing that presents a balanced analysis of a topic. So you're going to give an information piece of writing to the reader that that's a fact, and you wanted to convey the fact to the readers. And here you have to use giving an examples of statistics and examples because it is you are talking about a fact. And the fourth one is a persuasive essay. So in a single phrase, I have given that persuading is nothing but convincing the reader, convincing me. Me is the reader here. So whatever your argument topic, whatever your topic line of your essay, doesn't matter, but how good you are at convincing your reader. So you have to think about a topic where, for instance, you're saying that mobiles to be banned in colleges for students mostly. So if your essay is that, once after a reader reads your essay, the person should get convinced that yes, there are a lot many advantages of avoiding a mobile phone in a classroom or avoiding a mobile phone in a college. So that's how it should be. So after reading a topic, you should come to an understanding that yes, this kind of a topic comes under this kind of an essay. So persuasive in one phrase, nothing but convincing the reader. So whatever you're going to write, your introduction and the argument in the body of the paragraph, you're going to convince your reader with your evidences being shown in the essay. So these are the four types of an essays. Narrative. So in I'm just briefing out everything again. So how I do for all the classes. Okay. Narrative essays is just telling a story. And descriptive, so like a picture, you're going to describe a person, describe a picture you have seen. Expository, you wanted to just convey an information which is a fact. And that information is not a rumor, not a gossip. Okay, that's a fact everyone has known about. And a persuasive essay is you are writing an essay just to convince the reader. So these are the four major types. See, there are many kind of essay types, but I have explained here just the four major types which will be useful for you for your everyday uses of writing. So four major types of essays: narrative, descriptive, expository, and persuasive kind of an essay. So that's all about types of an essays, and thank you.